Chicas were a bit of a disaster because we worked with General Motors and they were not a good supplier. And at one stage they would not supply us anymore. Oops. Sorry. Stop running, where is it?
On cost, plus, that's fast.
On charge.
And
so we ended up having a whole bunch of cars in progress and no mechanical parts to mount in them, and we needed to keep the shop occupied. Sorry, I paused. Sorry.
No problem.
Anyway, that car that you saw there before was a replica of the SS Jaguar, which a gentleman by the name of Ed Felbin of Philadelphia was having somebody in Italy try to build, but they just didn't manage to get any cars now. So he found out about Frank and came to see Frank, and so Frank, we took the job because it was a job which we needed at the time. And he actually built 51 of them. 50 went to Felbin in Philadelphia. And one was sold to a young man called Tobian, who was a test driver for the March motorcycles. Anybody ever heard of March motorcycles?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, okay. And he happened to come down to look at the Lindra, and he saw one of these replica Jaguars and fell in love, so he built them. He came to pick it up on a March motorcycle. It was fun.
Paul, were those steel body or fiberglass?
That was the first fiberglass body.
Okay, so I thought.
All the other cars before, except the IMP, were steel. The IMP was aluminum. And the first Apollo was aluminum, but everything after that was steel. So, one way or another, we ended up in California. We were supposed to be building the engineer in California, but that didn't work out. So, one day Frank was going down to San Diego to talk about the IMP to somebody, and he happened to drive by car dealership. And saw three old speedsters there for sale. So on the way back, he stopped there and talked to the man and said, hey, how much are they selling for? And he wanted something like $10,000 each. So Frank said, that's an incredible price. He says, oh my God, if I had 20 of them, I could sell them next week. So Frank's ears picked up and looked at the speedster and figured, hey, thinking of Max, says, well, I want to make a fiberglass body, bolt it to a short thing, and I'm glad it should work. So, within a couple of weeks, we found that someone beat up speedster up in the Santa Susana Pass in San Fernando Valley and made a deal with the guy that we would return it to him in a couple of months or so, ready to be painted, cherry down in primer, ready to be painted. So we told the car to our carport, and first thing Frank did, of course, had to take it apart.
Yeah.
And modify the insides temporarily, so that you could actually make a fiberglass shape, because sheet metal, you can't make fiberglass the shape of the sheet metal. And I guess within about 3 months, maybe 4 months, we actually managed to build the mold for making the speedster. And while that was being done, Frank worked with Dean Moons, who was a friend of ours, and used to supply him valves and things from Italy. And there he showed him, he up in the pan and made a subframe for the inside and actually mounted the body there. And eventually the car was black, it was black gel, but it stayed black. And then we rebuilt the engine on our kitchen table. and bolted it all together, and Henry and Frank went for a test ride. It was a little memorable.
We were going to a shop.
Yeah. That's right. So they were driving down the 405 freeway with a hood flew off. Because Frank mounted in the front the original Porsche type VW Frank Goodlock, which was the single kind of the one that's the later one, which is the safety catch on it, and it just flew off. Anyway, so fortunately, we chipped and break. It was just a small scratch on the body, so we built a new front hood. Bolted it together. And after this, we tried to sell the car directly, as a kit and so on, but it's not that easy.
Is that car still around?
I don't know. We sold it to Tony Baumgartner, and he sold it to somebody in Orange County, of course, later. Anyway, we couldn't really get the business off the ground, so Frank had been contacted before by a guy called Tony Baumgartner, who was a part owner of a VW, very big VW dealership in Orange County. And so Frank called him up one day and said, hey, would you be interested in seeing something interesting? So Tony said, sure, come on. So Frank drove the first piece drove and then parked the paint truck in the windows. It was a riot. Everybody came running up looking at the thing. Just thinking it's fantastic. There were no other Speedster replicas before. This was the first one. So I think it was less than a week. We had an agreement with Tony and then the partnership. And within the next 2.5 years, we built 600 Speedster kits. They were all designed to be put on short VW vans, and because of the way the laws were set up at that time in California, we couldn't assemble the bodies to the chassis. But of course, we had a couple of subcontractors who could do it, so if somebody wanted to buy a running car, it was done that way. Right? And